Like staring to the woodlands, reminiscing, thinking they will make lemonade of our condition. Wishing, foreshooting, some more forgiveness, superstitions. Reaching out for true religion to widows, inclinations. Contemplating is complicated of complications. Memories that got me thinking, will I make it? With sanity,
taking the same pictures as a virtual, like a waiter out of waiting. Now it's all about 7 bars and deprecated. Then deprecate this decimated society on its premise. But hey, Miss Sunshine of Knowledge, please shine on these young minds and help us not acknowledge that money's not what we need to change this, for we're worth more than the figures on a payslip. So, time to bring our dreams to reality and draw up from the banks of our fantasies. Yes. Righty, yo, so I'm warmed up. My name is John Bernard. I do rap, but I've started doing spoken word quite recently. I enjoy words and I enjoy just writing. And this spoken word, it's untitled, but it touches on a lot of things I was going through. And I think, like, growing up, you kind of try a lot of things and you want to kind of be like whatever's kind of trendy at that time. But then I realized something, like, you know, we're all so unique and our uniqueness unites us. You know, we're all so gifted in so many different ways. But when we kind of forget that, that's when we try to be somebody else and the jealousy and envy comes in, and instead of playing our part, we begin to play other people's parts, and then that's when the confusion comes out and we become depressed because we fail to see, like, we are unique and we are called to do something amazing. So, but yeah, let's go. It's cancerous, the doctor retorted. Shifting my seat forward, trying to calm this stiff heartbeat that seemed like it was a second away from exploding. Speechless, pausing. Trying to grasp a galloping breath that was playing hide and seek in such a moment. How dare it? Are you okay, she said. From the stare she made, I knew she felt every part of the pain, like if we could swap seats, she would happily exchange hers for my place. We've known each other since Jenny Oliver's school meals, she's always been too real. Never afraid of the unknown. You know the type that always reject the blue pill because she's always believed that the truth healed. Well, who could have willed such an occurrence? Who could have foreseen such a deterrence? I've always told her if things went well, put a ring on it. As though marriage requires some type of preeminence. However, the evidence has shown her loving me through the negative, and if that weren't enough, then the remnant was relishing. Well, where do we go from here? During my teen years, life was about extenders and family affairs. See, we're hardly aware that I lied about a hundred stairs. From fun fest to functions to learning from assumptions and wholeheartedly dancing to a beat of the same drummer. Liberation like a waving white soul, surrendering more than its own honor. But growing up, sometimes it's like a cold summer. Liberation like a waving white flag from a surrendered soul, waving more than its own honor. But sometimes growing up is like a cold summer, expecting tranquility and serenity, yet growing up is known for its austerity. A wise man once told me we must keep in mind the brevity of life and the length of eternity. These two things will always alter what we chase and seek. All sweet complacency, I was compliant to your tendencies, tending to your every need, thinking I could capture lost moments because I had a gift that was irrevocable. Sleep, sleep. I call you up twice because thousands of times I'll snooze my alarm to have more of you. Or how I used to render you adorable. Now there's a possibility that my eyelids were shuttered to a costly stumble where dreams aren't affordable. I wonder, if there was a scheme through my life's chronicle, would they summarize whether this man was honorable, that my integrity was ostensible, or the stench of raw procrastination override it all? Brother told me, get on a bike, you riding for, but ride some more to the riding cause you to soar like an eagle on an open shore. I witnessed my heroes disappear like a puff of smoke. A passive hope enveloped in unsecured and erratic thoughts. They say we're the anchor, that we're captain our souls, as the son of Frog was the greatest of unknowns. I ponder the slippery slope, often physically trying to conceptualize whether we spiritually evolve. More than healing, I'm seeking exposure. Composure to have a straight back posture as I deal with failure, because I feel as though I had so much to give the world but couldn't get past the hysteria of exterior distractions. So, what will survive a man with no inheritance? Is life only fun when we're sipping on some beverages that affect sobriety like some prescribed sedatives? Is anything ever imperative? Will those to come know that we've ever lived? And please define legacy. And does this process entail jealousy? Will all of this echo in eternity or rebound off the ground in the cemetery? Are angels taking selfies with their celebrities, or does the grave render us nameless with no esteem? Shall the dream be the only luggage I'll carry to the final dwelling place? Guess if I had one more chance, I'd learn not to procrastinate.